Welcome back. Isaiah 39-41. Holy Father, create in us a clean heart, renew a right spirit within us, pour your Holy Spirit over us abundantly, give us joy to dreams and visions, clean our lives, clean our bodies, souls, and spirits. Holy Father, clean our country, the United States of America, in every way, shape, or form. In Jesus' holy name, write your word on the tablets of our hearts, Holy Father. Isaiah 39. At that time, Merodach Baladan, son of Baladan, king of Babylon, sent Hezekiah letters and a gift because he had heard of his illness and recovery. Hezekiah received the envoys gladly and showed them what was in his storehouses, the silver, the gold, the spices, the fine oil, the entire armory, and everything found among the treasures. There was nothing in his palace or in all his kingdom that Hezekiah did not show them. Then Isaiah the prophet went to King Hezekiah and asked, "What did those men say, and where did they come from?" "From a distant land," Hezekiah replied. "They came to me from Babylon." The prophet asked, "What did they see in your palace?" "They saw everything in my palace," Hezekiah said. "There is nothing among my treasures that I did not show them." Then Isaiah said to Hezekiah, "Hear the word of the Holy Lord Almighty. The time will surely come when everything in your palace and all that your fathers have stored up until this day will be carried off to Babylon. Nothing will be left, says the Holy Lord, and some of your descendants, your own flesh and blood, who will be born to you will be taken away, and they will become eunuchs in the palace of the king of Babylon." "The word of the Lord you have spoken is good," Hezekiah replied, for he thought there will be peace and security in his lifetime. "Comfort, comfort my people," says your holy God. "Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her hard service has been completed, that her sin has been paid for, that she has received from the Holy Lord's hand double for all her sins." A voice of one calling in the desert, "The way, prepare the way of the Holy Lord, make straight in the wilderness a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain will be made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain, and the glory of the Holy Lord will be revealed. And all mankind together will see it, for the mouth of the Holy Lord has spoken." A voice says, "Cry out," and I said, "What shall I cry? All men are like grass, and all their glory is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers and the flowers fall, because the breath of the Holy Lord blows on them. Surely the people are grass. Their grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of our Holy God stands forever. You who bring good tidings to Zion, go up on a high mountain. You who bring good tidings to Jerusalem, lift up your voice with a shout, lift it up, do not be afraid. Say to the towns of Judah, here is your holy God. See, the sovereign holy Lord comes with power, and his arm rules for him. He sees his reward is with him, and his recompense accompanies him. He tends his flock like a shepherd. He gathers the lambs in his arms and carries them close to his heart. He gently leads those that have young, who have measured the waters in the hollow of his hand, or with the breath of his hand marked off the heavens, who has held the dust of the earth in a basket, or weighed the mountains on the scales and the hills in a balance, who has understood the mind of the Holy Lord, or instructed him as his counselor. Whom did the Holy Lord consult to enlighten him, and who taught him the right way? Who was it that taught him knowledge, or showed him the path of understanding? Surely the nations are like a drop in a bucket. They are regarded as dust on the scales. He weighs up islands as though they are fine dust. Lebanon is not sufficient for the altar fires, nor its animals enough for burnt offerings. Before him all the nations are as nothing. They are regarded by him as worthless and less than nothing. To whom then will you compare our holy God? What image will you compare him to? As for an idol, a craftsman casts it, and a goldsmith overlays it with gold and fashions silver chains for it. A man too poor to present such an offering selects wood that will not rot. He looks for a skilled craftsman to set up an idol that will not topple. Do you not know? Have you not heard? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood since the earth was founded? He sits enthroned above the circle of the earth, and its people are like grasshoppers. He stretches out the heavens like a canopy and spreads them out like a tent of you live in. He brings princes to naught and reduces the rulers of this world to nothing. No sooner are they planted, no sooner are they sown, no sooner do they take root in the ground than he blows on them and they wither, and a whirlwind sweeps them away like chaff. To whom will you compare me, or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift your eyes and look to the heavens. Who created all these? He who brings out the starry hosts one by one and calls them each by name. because of his great power and mighty strength. Not one of them is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and complain, O Israel? My way is hidden from the Holy Lord. My cause is disregarded by my Holy God. Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Holy Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow weary. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow and tired and weary, and men and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Holy Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on the wings of, like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Be silent before me, you islands. Let the nations renew their strength. Let them come forward and speak. Let us meet together at the place of judgment. Who has stirred up one from the east, calling him in righteousness to his service? He hands nations over to him and subdues kings before him. He turns them to dust with his sword, to wind-blown chaff with his bow. He pursues them and moves on unscathed by a path his feet have not traveled before. Who has done this and carried it through, calling forth the generation from the beginning? I, the Holy Lord, with the first of them and with the last, I am he. The islands have seen it and fear. The ends of the earth tremble. They approach and came forward. Each helps the other and says to his brother, be strong. The craftsman encourages the goldsmith, and he who smooths with the hammer spurs on him who strikes the anvil. He says to the welding, it is good. He nails down the idol so it will not topple. But you, O Israel, my servant Jacob, whom I have chosen, you descendants of Abraham, my friend, I took you from the ends of the earth, from its farthest corners I called you. I said, you are my servant. I have chosen you, and I have not rejected you. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your holy God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. All who rage against you will surely be ashamed and disgraced. Those who oppose you will be as nothing and perish. Though you search for your enemies, you will not find them. Those who rage war against you will be as nothing at all. For I am the Holy Lord your God, who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, do not fear, I will help you. Do not be afraid, O worm Jacob, O little Israel, for I myself will help you, declares the Holy Lord your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. See, I will make you into a threshing sledge, new and sharp with many teeth. You will thresh the mountain and crush them and reduce the hills to chaff. You will winnow them. You will winnow them, the wind will pick them up, and a gale will blow them away. But you will rejoice in the Holy Lord and glory in the Holy One of Israel. Amen. Thank you, Holy Father. Okay, I'm trying to put my phone in another place. Ephesians 1:1-23. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus, by the will of our Holy God, to the saints in Ephesus, the faithful in Christ Jesus, grace and peace to you from our Holy God, our Father, and the Holy Lord Jesus Christ. Praise be to the Holy God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. For he chose us in him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in his sight. In love, he predestined us to be adopted as his sons through Christ Jesus, in accordance with his pleasure and will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he has freely given us in the one who he loves. In him we have redemption through his holy blood, the forgiveness of sins in accordance with the riches of our holy God's grace that he lavished on us with all wisdom and understanding, and he made known to us the mystery of his will according to his good pleasure, which he purposed in Christ to be put in effect when the times will have reached their fulfillment, to bring all things in heaven and on earth together under the head, even Christ. In him we were also chosen, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works out everything in conformity with the purpose of his will, in order that we who were first to hope in Christ might be for the praise of his glory. And you also were included in Christ when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your holy salvation. Having believed, you are marked in him with the seal, the promised Holy Spirit, who is a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance until the redemption of those who are holy God's possession, to the praise of his glory. For this reason, ever since I heard about your faith in the Holy Lord Jesus and your love for all the saints, I have not stopped giving thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers. I keep asking the Holy God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Holy Father, may give you the Holy Spirit of wisdom and revelation. Amen. Hallelujah. Give it to us abundantly, Holy Father, so that you may know him better. I pray also that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in the saints, and his incomparably great power for us who believe. That power is like the working of his mighty strength, which he exerted in our Holy Christ. Sorry about that. When he raised him from the dead and sealed him at his right hand in the heavenly realms, far above all rule and authority, power, dominion, and every title that can be given, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. And our holy God placed all things under his feet and appointed him to be head over everything for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills everything in every way. Wow, that's a lot. That's a chock full right there. Thank you, Holy Father. Thank you, Holy Father, for filling our lives in every way with holy treasures from heaven. Thank you, Holy Father, by the blood of Jesus, our Holy Savior and Messiah. Psalm 66, 1-20. For the director of music, a psalm. Shout with joy to our holy God, all the earth. Sing the glory of his name. Make his praise glorious. Say to our holy God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you. They sing praise to you. They sing praise to your name. Selah. Come and see what our holy God has done, how awesome his works in man's behalf. He turned the sea into dry land. They passed through the waters on foot. Come, let us rejoice in him. He rules forever by his power. His eyes watch the nations. Let not the rebellious rise up against him. Selah. Praise our holy God, O peoples. Let the sound of praise be heard. He has preserved our lives and kept our feet from slipping. For you, O holy God, tested us. You refined us like silver. You brought us into prison and laid burdens on our backs. You let men ride over our heads. We went through the fire and water, but you brought us to a place of abundance. I will come to your temple with burnt offerings and fulfill my vows to you. Vows my lips promised and my mouth spoke. When I was in trouble, I will sacrifice fat animals to you and an offering of rams. I will offer bulls and goats. Selah. Come and listen, all you who fear our holy God. Let me tell you what he has done for me. I cried out to him with my mouth. His praise was on my tongue. If I had cherished sin in my heart, the holy Lord would not have listened. But our holy God has listened and heard my voice in prayer. Praise be to our holy God who has not rejected my prayer or withheld his love from me. Proverbs 23:25-28. May your father and mother be glad. May she who gave birth to you rejoice. My son, give me your heart and let your eyes keep my ways. For a prostitute is a deep ditch and a wayward wife is a narrow well. Like a bandit, she lies in wait and multiplies the unfaithful among men. Holy Father, teach us your decrees, create in us a clean heart, renew a right spirit within us, clean our lives, clean our bodies, souls, and spirits, clean our country, the United States of America, pour your Holy Spirit over us, give us joy to dreams and visions, pour abundant wisdom, revelation, knowledge, understanding, Issachar discernment, prophetic insight, Holy Father, in Jesus' holy name, amen.